This video contains adults playing X-Wing miniatures. Adult language is used. You have been warned. Welcome, everybody, to another fantastic game of X-Wing with commentary brought to you today by Raven Squadron for the Central Ohio X-Wing. We're looking at the Ohio Regional 2017 Round 4, so let's take another look at what we have in store for you today. We've got Jacob Corell flying Nerodantals with proton torpedoes, extra munitions, Deadeye, and guidance chimps. If you're going to run Nero, you're going to run her like that because that's balls deep. You've got Miranda Dodani with twin laser turret, homing missiles, long-range scanners, C-3PO, and a bag of sex, and then Gold Squadron pilot with a TLT. Two turntables and a microphone. Get fucked, son. Over here, we've got Jeremy Trad, who you're going to see on a later round running his fantabulous, ultimately exquisite, Dengaroo. Dengar with plasma torpedoes, overclocked R4, inertial damperinos, countermeasures, lone wolf, punishing one, Zuckus, and a bag of fucking hammers, along with Manaroo with seismic torpedoes, unhinged astromech, black market slasher tools, engine upgrade, push the limit, gonk, and of course, a bag of something else. Right. Oh, we've got me today. I am LP. Who else do we have? We've got Daniel Fiorentini. Say hi, Daniel.
Hi, Daniel.
Excellent. Nice to see you. And we have David, the master of the bombers, the master of the clit himself. This is David Carver. Say hi, David.
Hey, David.
Fantastic. I love it. I can just count on you guys to be the straight man to the jokes that I try to shove right in your faces.
Hey, we like you because you like to shove it in our face.
That's you shove right, a lot friend. Of things in our face.
I've got you all trained so well. It makes me feel good. So we're placing, looks like we're placing asteroids here. It looks like Jeremy is, what the fuck, who has initiative? I'm assuming it's Jeremy because he's got a really short list. He's got like, what, like 94 points or something like that?
Yeah, yeah. Jeremy's got like 96 points. I think Corell is sitting about 100 points right now.
Yeah, but if you'll notice, it looks like that, looks like every bit of Jeremy putting out his first asteroid. So he's going with a 3-2 position. So just a little bit something extra.
It's actually a 3-3.
Did you do the 3-3? Okay. That's right. He set it off the board.
Yeah,
right?
He was off the board.
Why not just have an extra range ruler, man? I mean, how many of us have like 87,000 range 3 rulers?
I got about 4.
Yeah, I got 100. So, I mean,
that's because you buy everyone's collections.
That's right. Don't forget, guys, money cannot buy happiness, and money does not buy skill at X-Wing. Money just buys you toys. If money could buy you skill at X-Wing, I would be Paul Heaver. So, and I'm not. Because I suck real bad.
So, nah, you do better once you get outside the local meta.
Yeah, well, again, we talk about this a lot. Central Ohio has a ton of really good players. We've got a lot of good players. Like 9 people out of the Raven Squadron made it into the top 40 at the Springfield Regional. We got a ton of really good players. And it just so happens that I am a mediocre player in a land of giants, so I get shit on a lot. It's really like a German Scheisse film whenever I play X-Wing around here. But looks like more things flipping around. Looks like he's going for another range 3 rock. Interesting placement. I'm kind of curious about, or is this a range 3, range 2 rock? I guess it is 3-3.
Yeah, he's
it's about range 3, range 3.
So just out of curiosity, friends, is there a particular reason why you might place your rocks like that? Because technically it's at range 3, so it's really at range 2.5. So it's 3 from the edge, 2.5 up.
It gives you a little bit more in for these guys, particularly since they like to sloop around and stuff. Yeah. It gives them some ability to how close they can go through and sloop, whether they're going to be off the edge of the board or
I gotcha.
Not. So
if you start on a corner with a big ship facing diagonal towards the opposite corner, you can do a sloop without any concern for landing on the rock.
Is this some of that 22-degree bullshit that they're working on?
I don't know anything about this 22-degree bullshit. I just know I just put my ship in the corner and face the opposite corner, and I know I will not land on a rock if I sloop.
Yeah.
That's all I know.
We need Hussein on here to go through and give us all this math stuff.
God damn it, Hussein, why are you not here?
Math flies over my head. So, well, it doesn't really fly over my head. Just this 22 degrees thing makes no sense to me.
It all comes down at the end. You're all going to be rolling dice anyways, and dice are always going to fuck you when you don't want it to.
in the drive-thru.
Yes.
Backseat of a Volkswagen. So looks like he's setting up a one-range rock there. I am always kind of fascinated when I see a big cluster of rocks, like right in the middle of the board, especially when you see ships that either A, aren't that maneuverable, or B, are very large.
Oh, my Hawks, when I fly them, love to see this setup like this because they go hide on the rocks.
Yeah, actually, I had a really good game over the weekend where I flew an Upsilon clear through an asteroid field. Amazing, amazing piloting on my part, if I do say so myself. But that meant that my Upsilon was like a couple of turns out of the fight, and I totally got my ass kicked. Thanks, Dave Talbot. Love you, buddy. So,
here's a question.
I love the sideways deployment on the Y-Wing, by the way. It's like, oh, yeah, so we totally can't tell that you're going to too hard in.
He could go straight. But here's something I want to point out. Why do people bring two debris and one asteroid?
I bring two debris and one asteroid.
But why?
I like the debris because I like ships. Well, for one, I've got my ship du jour has been an Upsilon shuttle. I fucking love the Upsilon shuttle. It makes me hard. Flying a lot of TIE SFs. And a TIE SF with a pattern analyzer, if you catch the debris, who gives a shit? Because the debris doesn't stop your action. It's the stress that stops your action when you fly over debris. So you push the check pilot stress step after the action step.
So why do you bring that debris?
I bring the debris.
Why do you bring the one asteroid?
Mainly because I always forget where my extra debris are, and I bring the mustache rock because the mustache rock is Satan.
Yes, it is. The mustache rock, you're 9 times out of 10, when you don't think you're going to hit it, you're going to hit it.
Mustache rock has won me games. Mustache rock run me a game over the weekend. Mustache rock wins games.
I can understand it's super small.
Yes, and that's what screws
but,
you up.
But are we looking at this game here? There are four large asteroids and two large debris.
Mm-hmm.
I guess I want to have a long-term discussion with people. Is why do you not just bring one or the other instead of being indecisive?
I don't know that it's being indecisive, man. I think that's planning for potential contingencies.
You clearly made the decision to bring one, the asteroid.
But you bring the one asteroid because it's approximately the same size as the debris, right?
That's true. Yeah, oh, that could be a valid argument because it's a large size.
Trying to go through and you get the large size out there to go through. And if you happen to get them to run on the asteroid, then, yeah, you're going to get damage either with a hit or a crit. And they're not going to be able to go, they're not going to shoot, then they're not going to go through and do stuff. Whereas stress, well, yeah, the debris, you want to bring it because you want to possibly get people to get some stress. I mean, that's the only reason to go through and do it. Or if you think you're going to go through and land on the debris yourself, well, you get the stress and you still get to shoot. So.
All valid options. I just question it every time because you don't see one debris, two asteroids. Why don't you see that?
I do. I've done it.
But why?
I wanted more rocks, but I also wanted to take the debris token and stick it off like right in the middle of the board.
In a weird place so that you can catch somebody by surprise. Yeah. Yeah, the tournament I played at over the weekend, they had one of those mats that actually has a pre-built-in debris field like printed onto the mat.
That is confusing as hell.
So Dave and I automatically Dave Talbot and I put our rocks on the debris field just to screw with each other.
And it looks like the wide wing's going off and doing a...
Oh, he did a one soft. What a dick. He did nothing of what we declared. Asshole. So... good old Y-Wing, flippity-dippity.
And Manaroo is just going to go straight on across the board here, looks
doing
like.
Manaroo bullshit. Yep. Chucking Manaroo across the board. Okay, so now that Manaroo's done, we've got Neera at PS5, then Miranda at PS8, and then, of course, Dengo at PS9. So Neera taking a 2 straight, going just zipping right ahead.
Going charge!
I really love Neera Dantles. If there was a B-Wing that I was going to play, it'd be her, because there's nothing quite as awesome as having a turreted torpedo.
Yeah, I mean...
That's really
and
cool.
And really, to me, that's the way torpedoes should be.
Yeah.
If you got a target lock, they should be...
They should fly in any direction. Yeah. Who gives a shit? I get you.
You only say that because you fly munitions only.
No, I do not just fly munitions only. Sometimes I fly Chaos Boys.
Good old Chaos Boys.
Okay, other than that, you fly munitions and bombs.
Well, then 5 quad jumpers.
Okay, so he long-range scannered over
Doesn't
there.
Doesn't count.
So notice that he popped the long-range scanners to get the target lock onto Dengar.
Right.
So Miranda's got the Dengar lock. Now Dengar is making a... Was that a four straight? Nice.
It's just charging right,
right
on in.
Yep. Through the fucking rocks. Yeah. Looky there. Nice little zippity-doo-dah. Checked. Of course, he's going to be at
Mike
range.
Mike Jones target lock.
He's like range 4.5, so no target lock return. This is going to be interesting because you've got, in essence, three turreted ships against two turreted ships when you get right down to it. Because Nira is going to be doing her best to fire torpedoes, at least until she runs out, and then she becomes just a fixed-fire ship.
Right.
But Nira can just do a flyby and torpedo your ass on the way past. It's right. Really cool.
And she's just got, she's got Deadeye, so she doesn't. All she needs to be is within that range 3 area to go through and fire those off.
Yeah, because let's not forget that countermeasures on Dengadugo will, of course, block a target lock, but it won't get rid of a focus token.
Right.
But when Dengar pops countermeasures, then everything gets shit on. Let's see here. Looks like just some contemplation over dice, trying to figure out who's doing what. I'm assuming we're getting ready. I guess he's trying to figure out his action. Yeah. Is he trying to fit a barrel roll in?
No, yeah, he's trying to fit a barrel in right now.
See if he can fit one in there. Nope.
Nope, Chuck Testa. So I'm just going to probably take a focus or do nothing or just jack off. Who knows?
Well, this probably, this goes to this little focus token being tossed in there. Nothing's going to happen.
You know, with this matchup, though, it's really hard to get a good alpha strike on the Dengar is when you're relying on munitions. Because a lot of Mirandas run this one homing missile build where you just kind of pop it off in the initial engagement. You get to roll 5 die because it's Miranda.
Right.
And you take off a bunch of shields. Cool. But countermeasures is a thing in this matchup, and you just lose that first opportunity to do so, and it's really hard to come around.
Well, I feel like in this case, though, if you're Miranda, then you save the, you just TLT him to death with the Y-Wing. So, like, you bring, so Miranda comes in and TLTs, you know, pops an extra die on a few things. TLTs the shit out of him. The Y-Wing TLTs the shit out of him. And instead of going for alpha strike, you go with chip damage until he countermeasures. And then after the countermeasures are done, then you go for the alpha.
Right.
At least that's the way I'd do it. But keep in mind, it's not like I'm very good. So I just don't know if that's even feasible. Man, because I feel like the Dengar is going to shit on a fool.
Yeah, it's going to be a difficult matchup and stuff for him. It all depends on how Nira goes through and gets off those missiles. So if they can get the torpedoes off to strip off those shields and allow the or let the K-Wing or to go through and strip off some shields and let Nira go through and strip off and then ping him to death with the Y-Wing.
Yeah.
I mean, but
because three dice on two, you're going to ping a fool.
Right.
You're just going to die.
It looks like the Y-Wing is going ahead and doing a three bank there, trying to get into that TLT range there.
Yep. Because no matter where Dengar ends up, I mean, Dengar very likely is going to end up kind of coming in left.
Right.
I guess that's kind of my opinion. Yeah. But Dengar also has to get the hell away from Manaru in order to get the
Lone Wolf
kicked right. in. Yep.
Any movement here will almost guarantee that, though. So that's not really a concern. Because,
I mean, right now, Dengar can't one hard right because he's going to end up on an asteroid field, and that's going to be a little awkward. He'll be on the debris, I mean.
Yeah.
If he two hards right, then he should be able to barrel roll in and get within range one of Nira Dantil so she can't pop her torpedoes. But then again, she'll just turn around and shoot you with 4 fucking dice. So it's not exactly a kind thing to be in range one.
See, here, I would just go
after...
I feel
like he's going to go two straight, three straight?
Nope, not doing the two bank.
Two bank.
Ah, interesting.
He's thinking Dengar is going to go after Miranda and the Y-Wing, which I would do with Dengar, because I'm looking at this, and he's like, Miranda shooting back at the jump master that is Dengar. Eh, 3 die back, possibly 4 die, however close you are.
So, by the way, let's place our bets here. So what do you think Jeremy's thinking? I mean, if Jeremy was crafty, if he was going to play crafty and kinky, he makes a 2 hard right, ends up right before the rock, barrel rolls in, gets out of Nira's arc front, and then turns around and turret fires on Nira.
Right.
Or you say crafty and kinky, he does have inertial dampeners.
And
oh, no.
One streak.
Forget everything I said.
Yep. It's a one straight.
Yeah, so he is going for Nero like I thought. I mean, I would have liked the hard maneuver, but, you know, maybe you get close to too close to the rock in that case. But so he's in TLT range. He's outside of missile arc range from Miranda. So Miranda doesn't have missile arc.
He's gonna end up taking some proton torpedoes from
looks like
around.
He'll probably take a torp and four TLT shots. However, if you
that's not
cards
a good
right,
that's not a good start. But then you pop here is where we're talking about that opportunity for countermeasures.
Mm-hmm.
And here I would if it looks like he's taking two TLT shots and the missile.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I would definitely pop the counter here. But we'll find out. And about
there's the pass off.
Passing off.
Yep,
and
there we go.
There's the countermeasures. Yep. So it gets rid of Nira's Miranda's target lock.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And that's okay because Miranda was outside of front arc anyway, so all she can do is TLT.
And looks
and
like
Glitterstim.
Glitterstim.
No, that is a missile.
It's like a pistol. Oh, it looks like a
plasma. That's a plasma.
Yeah, yeah, he has plasma.
Oh shit. Yeah, he's
gonna
plasma torp at this point.
Try to strip off the shields off the B wing. So he can then double tap it.
Yeah, and then just kill Nira right off. That's a good point.
That'd be really sad. One turning a B wing.
Oh, you could one turn a B wing real easy.
It looks
I'm sure.
We roll on that.
But it's just that would be sad.
Two hits, looks like.
Yeah, looks like two hits and dodges.
Zuckus.
Yeah,
doesn't matter.
He's going to have to make him Zuckus, I get.
Oh, yep. No, he just. Oh, I guess that was blanks.
Yeah.
Because he doesn't want to spend it. So that was.
It's two blanks. So
two shields going off the. Actually, three shields off the B wing since it's plasma.
Yeah, right. So he's got two shields left. He's got five total damage points left.
So it looks like he didn't opt to Zuckus that time.
I don't think he needed to because
he didn't dodge any.
He rolled blanks to miss.
Right, but did he really only hit two with the plasma torps?
Yeah.
Oh,
hit two.
Okay.
But all he needed to hit was two because don't forget extra plasma.
Right. No, I understand that. I guess I was just wondering.
So he's looking, am I going to flip it or am I not?
Yeah, he's got three hits.
He only rolled three dice. Why did he not fire his proton torpedo?
No, this is a TLT shot.
Oh, okay, got it.
Yeah, this is Miranda shooting.
Oh, that's Miranda, right.
Yeah, Miranda shooting. And it looks like...
Looks like enough dodges to get out of the way.
That's one shield.
One shield, okay.
One shield off of... Ingar.
Okay, so that's his TLT.
Oh, no, there was a Zuckus there. Where was that? Yeah, they got stressed. So there was...
No, that was the Glitterstim.
Oh. Glitterstim. Yeah, Glitterstim gives stress.
There was no Glitterstim pop, though.
I thought he popped two cards.
It was countermeasures and plasma torps.
No.
Yeah, I don't know where the stress came from the...
See, we actually need five people and multiple dice cards.
Wait, does... No, the White Wing... I was like, does the White Wing have a stress spot? No, that's not true. It's not true in this instance.
So Miranda's shot. Now we're off to Nira Dantolino's.
They didn't want
to... Fire the missile, dude.
Yeah, you're that close.
You shoot.
You're going to die. Fire the fucking missile.
He's trying to debate whether he wants to shoot at it at all. Nope, he's not taking the shot.
I think that's a mistake.
Here's the thing, though. That is a valid point.
Right.
I mean, the reason why is that he takes a Nira Dantel shot, right? And so he gets four dice, and then Jeremy gets to dodge with four dice. He's tokened up.
Yep.
And
he doesn't have a token on them right now.
So at best, he might only get a couple of damage through. And then Dengar turns around and has a chance to fire three dice right back at him that he gets three dice to dodge, two dice to dodge
which
with.
Which is what I think Jeremy was hoping that he would go through and do is so he could pretty much wipe Nero off the board.
Yeah, he could one turn.
I guess. I think you... Because I don't think there was a token on Dengar. Was there a token on Dengar, a focus token?
Well, I don't know.
He got it from
from
Amaru.
Right, but did he get the... Oh, no, yeah, no, you're right. So he did have focus token. Maybe it was the right call then. Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Maybe it was the right call.
Yeah, the only time I go through and joust Dengar is if I've got, like, four bombers and then...
Or if you got two ships in his front.
Two ships in his front. He's got to shoot at one of them, but you're going to get two shots off, so...
Yeah, your goal is to give Dengar too many ships to shoot back at, so he has to choose which one to shoot at, and then your other ships definitely get to shoot. Because if he decides to not Let's say you've got like if you got two ships, if he doesn't if he doesn't revenge shot your first one, you don't shoot with the second, because then you've just saved extra damage.
Right.
If you got three ships facing down, and you've got your big bad nasty that's going to fire last, you fire your first two guys, and then you don't fire with the big bad nasty. Your goal is to try to get him to not use that extra shot, because and then once he uses the extra shot, everybody else is immune to damage. Right now, Nero was the only shot that he had.
Right.
No,
so,
you're right.
So
that's
if he
true.
Nero's, so if Nero fires, he's going to revenge shot the shit out of him.
You know, if we had Mike Jones or Hassan here, they'd be saying, "No, you guys are full of shit."
Maybe.
But why is that? Why are we full of shit?
No. We
always take
no,
the
we,
shot, right?
Well, we always are, because we always think different than what they think. So.
Hassan's a math guy. He looks at the stats.
Which is why I always have fun debating with him on stuff, because dice are always going to end up in the equation.
Never trust a die, man. Never trust a die.
Red dice you can trust a little bit more, but not too much.
Again, you got a 75% chance of getting a paint result.
Right.
That's a pretty good odds.
So now the Y-Wing's getting
fucked in there.
Saying I'm coming right on in.
He's going really fast with that Y-Wing. I would have just gotten straight. That's just me, though.
And Manaro just going rolling around on the outer skirts there.
But not too far out. You'll notice that. I mean, because the fight's taking place in the middle, right. Manaru's not getting too far away.
Yeah, no, she could merge right on in there if you wanted to.
Now, the interesting part is where does the B-Wing go? The B-Wing can't K-turn right now because a K-turn, I think, is going to catch the corner of that asteroid. Or, I mean, debris, you know, same shit. So do you like one soft? He's
gonna
he is going to K-turn, son of a gun.
Nope. No.
Too straight.
Well, remember, he could just shoot munitions wherever he wants.
Doesn't matter what you long.
True. Season. Yeah, that's a valid point. That's a valid point. Because I keep thinking of like traditional B wings where he wants to get that front arc in. So he's just gonna two straight and then hope that Dengar flies past him.
Right.
And then if he has to use the focus token for defense, he will.
Either way, that Dengar's gonna have to go over that rock there.
Yeah.
Yes, very much so. Well, no, this one has inertial dampeners, remember. I wouldn't stay there, personally, but...
Does he pop it? Nope.
Nope,
he's going to move, and he's got a bump.
Inertial dampeners isn't such a bad move there, because he's at range one of the TLT, so no shot. He's at range one, almost out of arc, of the... B-Wing.
And then
the B-Wing doesn't get to torpedo him. So he bumps onto the B-Wing and therefore is immune to torpedoes for this turn. And he is is he bumping the B-Wing or is he bumping the Y? Or does he hit both?
That's what I think they're trying to measure that.
Holy balls. He might have hit both.
I really doubt he hit both. Let's
see. If he hit both, that was skillful. That was the best bump he could have made because he basically mitigated... All that damage.
Looks like it gets hit to B-Wing. It's the B-Wing moves.
Yeah, so the Y basically gets to give him like three whole dice of damage.
Yeah.
And the Y is the Y. The Y's in his arc,
unfortunately. Yeah, the Y's in his arc, definitely. But I wouldn't shoot with the Y.
But Miranda gets to tap a tappa.
Yeah.
I don't think I'd shoot with the Y here. Or even if you do, I mean, it's potential. His countermeasures are gone.
And nothing for the
asteroid.
Field.
Yeah. The Asteri field. He's got a D20 out for his stress. I love it.
Yeah, well, I used to red when I was running Zuckus. I used a red D20 to keep track of everything.
You don't think FFG gives you enough stress tokens, man?
Not enough for the acrylic
stress
ones.
Are jank.
Plus, I don't want to go through and clutter up the board any more than I have to.
Ah, but mind games. You clutter up the board, confuse tokens.
No, that's why you have a huge D20 die that you set right now next to the ship.
Use that as one of your asteroids.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And it looks like...
Dengar shoots first.
Yep.
Looks like
three hits?
Yep, three hits, it looks like.
And one dodge die. Has another
and
stress.
Zuck
can re-roll the dodge die. And I bet we're going to see... Three shields disappear off that Y-Wing. Actually, didn't yet. Two shields come off the Y-Wing.
So the three hits.
He's now at range two, it looks like. Was that range two? I couldn't quite tell. I think it was range two.
Yeah, it was about range two.
So it's range two. He's going to TLT him, I guess. First shot. Looks like three paint results.
And yeah, that's three, so that's automatic one damage.
Yep, so there's a shield. And now the second shot of the TLT looks like maybe one or two paint results.
Another damage. There
not
you
enough.
Go.
So he's taken Dengar down to one two shields, and he's got five hull left. Nerodantel still lives. If you're Nero, do you basically three straight this next turn? To try and get range so you can torpedo turret?
Possibly. I mean, you want to get her out of it. If you're going to get her ordnance off, that's where her bread and butter is. You've got to get her out of the
Yeah, she
danger
needs some
zone.
Range, but you still need to keep up that blocking game. Again, we talked about this before. The secret to beating Dengar is block fucking Dengar, or only shoot when you've got multiple ships in the arc that can. So he has to choose what to shoot back.
Or
at.
You have enough ships to blow it up faster than he can.
Or you
do.
Just shoot the hell out of it. Hit him with a bunch of TIE fighters.
Yeah. Four Gamma Squadron bombers.
That works,
all with
too.
All with ordnance.
Oh, yeah. He dropped four missiles on him. He's got to make a choice. Like, what do I die from? What do I revenge shot?
I am so tempted to bring those bombers back out again.
Oh, by the way, so notice, obviously, just like we talked about, the Y-Wing did not take the reverse shot. So the Y-Wing chose not to shoot in order to preserve revenge damage.
Right.
I always feel dirty shooting primary Y-Wing. It's like, oh, two die. Yeah.
Pew, pew.
Try shooting one primary with a hawk.
Yeah, that's terrible.
I don't fly hawks.
You should.
Actually, I don't own a hawk, actually.
They're fun. Hawks are fun little ships.
You got to at least go through and buy one hawk so you can get Rourke.
They need to have a combat retrofit for the hawk where they kind of... I was talking to a guy up in Cleveland about this. They need to be able to retrofit the hawk to give it maybe like an extra shield and an extra firepower out the front. And like call that like 7 or 8 points or something like that, like combat retrofit. So therefore, you're running around with like a 4-hull, 2-shield ship or a 5-hull, 2-shield ship.
Well, I guess it actually just needs an extra firepower for free.
It was a pretty shittily designed ship.
Yeah, they even went in the past. They even go through and said that one of their biggest mistakes was giving a one primary die to the Hawk.
No other ship has a one primary die, correct?
No.
And because it's impossible to hit anything with a one primary weapon.
When big ships like Decimator can evade it at range 3, then you know something's wrong.
No shit. Okay, so the Y-Wing, what's he going to do? 4 straight? 3 straight? So you're going to hard turn in.
Don't see
like
what they're doing.
Looks like a two hard.
Too
yep,
hard. Yep. Okay.
Pretty simple. Makes it too hard, takes a focus probably, or target locks, one of the two. There's
it's
his focus.
It's a TLT.
Now the question is, where's Nero going to go? After we do, of course, we already know where Manaru's going to go. Manaru's just going to go hang around off to the side there.
I think that Nero either, because if she three hards, that's a red maneuver on a B-Wing, so she can't focus. I think she's got to go 3 straight or 2 hard. Because she needs that focus token.
Right.
She needs it desperately. Of course, I feel like that Dengar is just going to 2-sloop around and erase Nera.
We'll find out in a second. Oh, he goes too hard the other way.
Yeah. That's the too hard I was looking at.
Okay.
Now, barrel roll to block the 2-sloop.
I like your idea better.
Yeah, see, that's gonna fuck him.
We'll find out in a moment.
Yeah. But this is interesting. So he's assuming he makes the 2-sloop. I mean, he's stressed, but a sloop left is gonna cause no stress because it's white for a U-boat. He makes the 2-sloop. He's gonna have, I think, only the Y-wing in arc because I think the B-Wing will be just outside of arc. The Y-Wing will be in arc. I don't think Miranda's going to be in arc. So he's going to probably shoot at Nera. And if Nera lives, then she doesn't get any shots back. But then the Miranda will be shooting out of arc, and therefore not have to worry about revenge shots. Then the Y-Wing turns around and fakes it. There's his glitter stem, right?
Yep. Yep, and he gets increased his own
That's not glitter stem.
Or is that the counter? I thought he
That's inertial dampeners.
Already. Oh, the inertial dampeners.
He has inertial dampeners and countermeasures. He does not have glitter stem.
Well, that's right. Boo.
Yep, so he's in range one. Therefore, he gets to shoot Nira Dantles.
Yep.
Probably going to take 4 damage off.
Looks like it's 4 and did not evade.
Yeah, probably nothing. That's some brutality. And of course, he's at range one of the Y-Wing.
Yep.
So the Y-Wing can't TLT him back. Miranda will get to shoot him. This guy's flying Dengar so well.
He had one evade and made him.
Zuckus.
Made him Zuckus hit, yep.
So there's two shields and then...
Two damage.
Oh, he's got one hole left. Oh, kiss that B-Wing goodbye.
Yeah, Nira's not going to get the... Nira will probably get a shot off this game.
Nira's down to one hole left.
Yep, so there's a TLT coming in, I guess.
Yep. Takes one.
Yep. And second TLT. And checking out. Looks like he flipped a focus to an evade.
And
it looks like he just doesn't want to. He's trying to figure out, am I gonna flip it over and not take the damage? And it looks like he did. Because the Y-Wing is just too close.
Yep.
Y-Wing can't get the shot off. Masterful. This guy's really good.
Just feels so dirty watching. He has so many tricks with Dengar every time.
Because Dengar doesn't care about getting stressed because he's always going to get fed a focus token from...
Exactly.
But now...
You've just got to go through and... Nira not getting the missiles off and stuff is what's really killing it this game here.
Yeah, he should have taken that Nira missile shot in the beginning. He should have just taken it and then taken the extra revenge dice back. I mean, it's one of those things you can constantly second guess. I mean, I said, yeah, it's a good call, but maybe now it isn't a good call because now Nira's going to die with 2 missiles.
Yeah, I was about to say, it's like, weren't you the one debating saying, oh, it's not a good shot because it's 4 attack die and 4 defense die with 1 modification?
But it is. It's literally, there is no winner in there.
No, there isn't. You're right about that.
Because the initial time he's going out there, well, he's just going to get shit on. He's got 4 dice versus 4 dice. Because when he popped his countermeasures through a rock, it's 4 dice. So it's going to be 4 dice versus 4 dice. And Nira is only able to modify through chimps because she has to spend her focus token in order to fire the proton torpedoes. So all she can do is modify 1 die with chimps. And then... proton torpedoes lets her turn 1 focus to a crit.
Yeah.
So potentially she's looking at 2 crits if she rolls 3 blanks and a focus.
The sad part here is now that Nira's basically guaranteed dead,
yep.
If he gets an arc on someone else, he's just going to take the revenge shot for sure.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but he prioritized right on this. And the threat in this list was Nira to his Dengar.
Yeah.
I mean, okay... I sort of disagree with that part. It was more that the opening engagement was more beneficial for him sitting in that one position with countermeasures.
The other ones can go through. The 2 TLTs can go through and pick at him, but Nira could go through and...
Nira bursts him.
Yeah.
But now Nira...
You have to remember Miranda had a missile too.
Yeah.
And it got the countermeasures off and early. So
but
I think that was...
notice he's staying
that was with that was
he's
important.
Staying within range 3 of Miranda though. So Miranda with her long-range scanners can't retarget lock.
Yeah, 1 to 2. She's staying within
range 1. At
range
3,
one.
You can get the target lock back.
Yeah, range 3
you
can. Well, he's staying within range 1 to 2. So.
But yeah, that's what I mean.
That's what you mean,
staying within the, he's staying within minimum range of those long-range scanners. So now he knife fights Miranda and negates her burst capability.
Right.
So I mean,
he'll take the picking stuff, especially with Lone Wolf and stuff, so he can go through and minimize the damage that's coming in.
Yeah, Miranda's. Jeremy's no fucking slouch. He is really quite good at this. Looks like a K turn off of the TLT.
Yep.
That's the only way he would get out. More safely, maybe reset
Well, the nice thing that Miranda has going for her is that if she closes to range one, she can spend a shield and roll like a four die primary weapon attack.
My thing with that, though, is you're at range one against another four die primary.
Yeah, it is what it is. I mean, he's got to start putting damage in somehow. He's got to burst him down.
And that's right. No, I don't disagree with that. But at this point in the game, he's going to do more likely is two slooping north.
Unless Miranda, Nira Dantel's one hards in.
No, I'm saying he's going north.
Oh,
so
it's
the right side. If you're looking at,
yeah, I see.
He's going to the right side of the table.
But that's a red sloop, and he can't make red moves because he's stressed to hell.
Oh, that is a red sloop. You're right. So scratch that.
If he's going to sloop, he sloops to the left.
Yeah, scratch that. I don't know the Jumpmaster dial well enough to make low comments like that. I get confused on which one's the safe side.
Oh, Nira's going.
He's dead. It's just Nira's going to die without shooting. I mean, he's going to focus up here, sure, and just hope that...
All he really has to do is just go...
he's just one soft in at this point.
One soft in, or gets to go straight to get out of the range of Miranda that's coming in.
Yeah.
At least he didn't knock over the camera.
Nice. Let's see here. So, focused up with Miranda... Miranda's sitting at range one of Dangadodo. Is it the two Is it the two sloop? Let's see. Yeah. It's either going to be the two sloop or it's going to be like a one soft or like a one straight. He could just clear, just like we were talking about, he could just clear the debris and say, fuck it.
We'll find out in a moment. That arm is in the way.
No, one hard. One hard left, which is green, which clears a stress, which is funny. And he just shits all over near Dantel's. Yep, range one, so no return torpedo shot. Four dice versus one.
Yep, Nira's got to be dead.
Yep. That's a legit shame. Nira died without shooting a single torp. Just because of the way the engagement went.
Very much so.
It makes you wonder what would have been better, what would have been a better deployment with Nira. Do you put Nira with the group? Like, do you deploy the three ships in a formation and then use the TLTs almost to kind of do the blocking, use Miranda to block.
Basically, your offensive line to go through and block for you.
Yeah, like do you use Miranda actually as a blocker in this case?
It looks like set up the shot. Two hits.
He's deader than fuck.
Yep.
He's dead. No matter two hits is automatic kill.
Yep. And roll a blank
and a hit. Yep. So dead. Yeah. So I mean,
I agree with your point on the changing the initial deployment. Probably here, when you have ships that can, just lay the smack down on Dengar, you want to alpha strike them, and you want to just go as a clump and shoot as many hits as you can at the same time, because he's only going to be able to mitigate so much, and he's only going to be able to shoot back against so many ships.
Yeah.
So let's say, on that initial engagement. They were all together.
Yeah.
And Miranda took the first shot, the TLT shot. Mm. Now he gets to choose, okay, I'm going to shoot Miranda. Like, and the Dengar's facing the group. I'm going to shoot Miranda, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or I don't shoot Miranda, still get the two damage through with the TLT, and then you get the missile shot after. Okay, so cool. You still got a missile shot. You don't have you hopefully don't have the debris in the way this time.
Yeah, I almost kind of feel like maybe you use the Y-Wing as the blocker.
Use a Y-Wing as a blocker.
And then Miranda and Nira come in at
this
range two and do some DACA. Just some shots back. And it's like TLT time. He's rolling two dice for dodge.
And he
finally put some damage through. Nice. He's got him down to half strength.
He got him down to half strength now. Yeah, I had it updated wrong earlier, but now he's actually got him at half strength. So.
That's two hits back at the Y-Wing.
28.
And that's a Zuckuss. And Zuckuss makes me sad, man.
See, like, it almost looks like that he had a die on the debris there. I mean, I'm the kind of person that's always going to make you reroll a cock, and I will always reroll any of my dice that land partially on debris. I just do that.
No, and I'm with you on that, too, because
Because there's no official FFG rule about dice placement. Because, I mean, in 40K, what we would do is we would just set a die on top of another die, and if it would stay there, then it wasn't cocked.
Yeah, I think the tournament rules now state that if it's cocked, you re-roll it.
You have to re-roll. Yeah. It's just that's how the rules work. Yeah. So if the die is not sitting flush to the table, you re-roll that shit.
Right.
Because there's literally no other way to tell. He's got 4 damage to get through on Dengar. Think he can do it? Think he can kill a Dengar?
He can kill a Dengar. But my concern would then be, how does he punch through damage on the Manaroo? Because the Manaroo, we didn't talk about the Manaroo build too much. Seismic Torps, K4, Gonk, push the limit.
Manaroo is going to be really hard to kill, but as long as you can stay with range 3, you can kill Manaroo.
Right, you can just keep picking at her.
Miranda has to come out pretty healthy. That is for sure.
I mean, look at all the damage that those TLTs have put on. Those TLTs have put on over half damage.
Now imagine one missile into that.
If one torpedo would have gotten off, if one homing missile would have gotten off, that would be probably a dead Dengar.
Probably. I very much believe so.
But again, due to Jeremy's really excellent flying,
Here comes the White Wing charging in again.
So he's trying to block so Miranda can sloop around behind, I guess. I think he's just trying to block the two
That would
sloop.
Block the safe white sloop, yeah.
Miranda's probably just going to one soft or something goofy. Maybe two soft, try and get through the asteroid field.
There's a lot of easy options for the Miranda. The Dengaroo list is in such a good spot right now.
Oh, yeah. I mean, Dengar's down to 4 holes, sure, but at the same time, it's fucking Dengar. He's going to hurt you. What do you do? Two soft?
Yeah, two soft through the flying through the asteroid field.
No, is that a two soft or is that a three soft?
No, that's a two soft.
That's a two soft, yep.
Yeah, Miranda was set up perfect for it. Now, as long as Dengar doesn't do something real janky and like 4 straight or something. Yeah.
Bonk. Nope, he's just got a bump.
That was a good block.
He's only gonna take 1 TLT shot then.
Yeah.
I mean that's not a
and nobody ought to go through and start picking at Miranda with his
here's the problem with trying to pick at Miranda. You need to do 2 damage. More than 2 damage a turn to start punching through her health because she has 1 from C3, 1 auto evade from C3PO. Wait, no. You can modify the C3PO result with Zuckus. Yeah, never mind. Scratch that.
Yeah.
Scratch Zuckus, that. I forgot Zuckus, about that Zuckus, entirely. Zuckus. Why does Zuckus exist? Makes me so sad.
Because he's scummy.
It's so sad, man.
Act like the scum do. They go through make you do the shit you don't want to do, go through and do.
1 point best crew card.
Yeah, Zuckus is good. As long as you don't care about stress, right, like Dengar does. If you've got a Miranda there to give you tokens, you're good to go. So, looks like that Dengar fires at Miranda. It's out of arc, so no revenge shot.
Right. And
so Miranda can continue to TLT.
Yeah, Zuckus literally everything that she gets.
Did he not shoot?
Yeah, he's shooting.
No, the Dengar shoots first.
Yeah, Dengar shoots first. So it looks like 2 hits.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. Yeah, Jeremy's on the right. So it looks like...
Here's my question. So how's the timing on that work? Because I'm still getting used to the whole defensive modifying and offensive modifying results.
What do you mean?
So like Zuckus applies to C-3PO.
So, let's see.
Carver, you're the rules man. Explain it to me.
So first the...
I don't have it off the top of my head right now.
So
sorry.
The defender is...
I'm sure if I ask a question about a bomb, you would have known.
This is why I don't do well on like these type of quick questions and job interviews.
that's why we have Mesmore.
But that's why we have Mesmore. We have a lot of people who know these questions off the top of their head and memorize the FAQs and can tell you it's like, oh, that's an FAQ 4.6.2. I'm like, what? No? Yes, that's actually correct.
And it looks like Dengar took another damage. He's down to 3, it looks like.
Yeah, from the TLT.
Yep.
See, I don't like... Yeah, I really don't like how the position the Rebel will play right now. It's just so unfortunate that those missiles didn't go off earlier. One missile, that's a dead Dengar.
Yep.
It's just a dead Dengar, no matter what. And see, the one thing we also didn't consider, too, is that if since Nira has guidance ships, she turns one of the red die into a crit.
Yep.
Like,
and then
in a crit brew,
torpedoes is turn a focus result to a crit. So, like I said, even if you roll three blanks and a focus, you're still going to get two crits.
Exactly. And
odds are you're going to probably roll a hit, a focus, and two blanks. So that's one hit, two crit. So that'd be double crit sitting on Dengar right now.
That'd be pretty awesome. Granted, he had shields at the time, but still, it's enough. There's two more damage through.
Yep.
And then this will be a more doable game at this point.
Okay, so the timing chart, by the way. So the declare target step, you measure range, attacker chooses weapon, declare target of attack, pay the cost to perform the attack, target of the attack becomes a defender. That's in the declare target step. The roll attack dice step, identify number of attack dice, resolve abilities that increase or decrease the number of attack dice. Then, step three, modify attack dice step. These abilities include adding, changing, or rerolling dice results. The dice can be modified multiple times, but each die can only be rerolled once. Defender resolves abilities that modify attack dice.
Right.
Attacker resolves abilities that modify attack dice. Then we go over to the roll defense dice step. Identify the number of defense dice from the ship card. Resolve abilities that increase or decrease the number of defense dice. Modified defense dice step is next. These abilities include adding, changing, and re-rolling dice results. Dice can be modified multiple times, but each die can only be re-rolled once. Attacker then resolves abilities that modify defense dice, followed by defenders resolving abilities that modify defense dice.
So C-3PO, you roll your dice, you add an evade result. The attacker can then go through and modify.
Because C-3PO happens in the... would that be the roll defense dice step or the modified defense dice step?
It adds an evade, so like it adds an evade result. So
modify, that would be probably the right step for it.
Looking at cards.
It all depends on what the wording of the actual card is.
I'm glad that this game has a lot of clarifications like this, because I've played so many games where the rules are vague. You kind of have to make like almost house rules for these kind of games where you just don't know. These minute circumstances that probably wasn't playtested well enough come up and you're left with a big old question mark over your head.
Yeah, according to this, C-3PO says a ship equipped with both C-3PO and flight instructor can guess the number of evades, then add an evade if the guess was correct, then reroll if applicable.
All right, so it could...
So basically, adding a result, so therefore that's why C-3PO occurs on the timing chart in the...
Rolling up the defense dice.
Yeah.
And then the attacker gets to go through and modify it.
Right.
So. Right.
How sad. How sad.
So it looks like now that while I was sitting here reading...
The Y-Wing made a turn.
Yeah, it's a three bank.
Yep, and he got a stress. Strip.
Yeah.
And then it looks like
Manaru came in finally.
Manaru's going off over there, and she's going to start taking double hits from Manaru and Dengar.
I got to tell you, if I was Manaru, I would think about taking a shot at by popping the seismic torpedoes.
Why are you going to hurt your own ship?
Yeah, it'd just be funny.
Because I do it all the time.
Although, honestly, in all seriousness, seismic torpedoing, when it comes down to Miranda's turn, would probably kill Dengar. Because basically, Miranda is going to double tap Dengar.
Right.
The Y-Wing is going to double tap Dengar.
Yeah, and unfortunately, Dengar doesn't have the arc for the revenge shot, so...
Yep. So...
Kind of in a rough spot.
Yeah, Miranda and the Y-Wing are both in pretty good places right now.
But here's also the thing we want to point out. The Y-Wing only has two health. Oh, no. B-Wing has four health remaining.
No.
Forget everything I said.
Nothing there. Looks like three hits.
Looks like, three hits. One, two. So he's that three no hull. He's got what, four hull left on Miranda? Yeah, I think four hull left because Miranda's got what, seven hull? Or is Miranda five and four? I can't remember.
I'm pretty sure that's the Y wing that.
Yeah,
got
the
shot.
Y wing. The Y wing is the one that got ended up getting.
It's
shot.
The Y wing that got shot.
Yeah. So the.
So the Y wing has one hull left.
Gotcha. Yeah, because it's got three damage or four damage.
It looks like it's got three damage, so it's actually got some.
There's four damage cards
four,
on it.
Four damage cards.
There's four
on
damage
it?
Cards
okay.
on it.
So I missed some stuff when they shot at it earlier. So.
What would be the score right now, Carter?
It was right now it's 28-33. So Jeremy's winning right now. He takes off another ship. It's
pretty much game over at that point.
You spend that focus. Yes.
Focus.
What a trooper. Because you can kill this guy this turn.
Yeah, Miranda is 5-4. So four shields, five hull.
Yeah.
Okay, so it looks like he's... why is Jeremy still rolling dice?
Was it?
That was on Manaru, probably. Yeah, that was Manaru. That was definitely Manaru. So now here's the...
The Y-Wing there. Because he's Y-Wing. Just got... What does he have? Like one hull left? I can't say.
One hull left, yeah. Oh, natural evades. Why you do this? It'll betray him.
Versus, I think it's two
the
paints.
Die gods betrayed him this time.
Oh, well. What do you do?
Never trust to die. Never have faith
so
in the die.
So was Dengar lived with one hull, didn't he?
Yep.
Wow, that's brutal.
It looks like that's the case. Because I think I see four cards on it.
Well, if
it's four or two, I can't tell. I think it's two. He still only has three.
Is it two?
He's still at three.
Oh dear, that's even worse. Oh no, you're that glare makes it look so weird for me.
Yeah,
I feel like I'm looking at
it's two cards on Dengar.
I feel like I'm looking at like three different card edges.
Well, he also has some alternate arc cards that he brought with him as well. So he's got like double cards.
Oh, thanks for help make me feel better about myself here. I thought I was blind and I really needed my glasses today.
Yep.
I know them feels, buddy. I know them feels.
Yeah, I think he had some of the Paul LaRue alternate arc cards.
Those are great, by the way. Do we want to advertise another individual today?
Fantastic free advertising brought to you today by Raven Squadron. Oh, man. So what is it? That Y-Wing has what, like two hull left, one hull left?
It's like one hull left on the Y-Wing.
So brutal. You know, the Y-Wing and Miranda could potentially solo...
Manaru?
Could take out Manaru, but I don't think that Miranda can by herself kill both.
That she would have to run off and do a lot of regenning and coming back.
Oh, yeah. She had to slam away.
She doesn't have the build for it. She could... If this is an unlimited time game, maybe. You have to kill Dengar, because how do you play that out? It's basically sit at range three, so you get two evade die against the Jump Master.
Yeah, but at this point, there's about 23 minutes left in the match.
Yeah, there's no way.
Wow, so it looks like that Manaru boosted in just to get that range one shot, trying to get real close to range one.
That's not even
barrel
range
roll.
One.
That was actually a barrel roll in.
Did she barrel? I didn't see it from
Yeah, barrel rolled.
Nice.
And Miranda just running off.
That's what she's got to do at this point.
Why? Like, what? Why do you run away at this point? Don't you stay
you,
in and try
you
and
want? Because if you kill Dengar this turn, or like the turn after,
Dengar shoots before the Y-Wing, so Dengar likely is just going to shoot the Y-Wing.
And it looks like he does not touch that.
No. So at least my idea would be you're flying away. I wouldn't have three banked there. I probably would have like two hearted trying to just pray.
Well, it looks like Miranda still has shots on Dengar.
Yeah, you're getting shots, but the idea was you fly away so the following turns, the Manaru can't keep shooting you.
Well, I mean, so Dengar probably shoots the Y-Wing.
Right.
Miranda shoots Dengar.
Miranda gets a shot back.
Yeah, then Manaru, if the Y-Wing for some stupid reason lives, shoots the Y-Wing. Otherwise, Manaru shoots Miranda.
Correct. It's just an all-in-all bad situation.
Yeah, it's not pleasant.
Which way would you rather get cucked, like in the front or back? I don't know.
Basically, the nasty part. Miranda's now set up in revenge shot range. So she shoots Dengar, and even if she kills Dengar's going to shoot her again.
Correct.
So Miranda takes every bit of three shots this turn. She's going to get, well, she's only going to take two shots.
I think the
Y-Wings
are going to be gone this turn. I think he's checking which one he's going
to do. One hole, two shots, lone wolf reroll, focuses. Nah, the Y-Wings got this, dude. Y-Wings got this in a million years.
Yeah, because he can't afford to leave. Even though it'd be really nice to be able to put three shots into Miranda in one turn, he's got to kill the Y-Wing.
Let's see Let's see how many dice he's rolling here.
They're both only one.
Yeah, I know.
Well, two, technically, because of range. Miranda could roll up to... Miranda can only roll two because it's range three.
Right.
No rock.
All right, it's three dice.
Oh, look, three natural hits.
Looks like three pieces of paint.
And...
There's just no reason even.
Woo! Two, three hits. One, two, three.
Wowing blows up.
Yep, that's
now Miranda shoots at
and the
Dengar
Y-Wing goes away.
So Miranda, if I was Miranda, I'd spend a shield now because you got to guarantee the kill because he hasn't. I don't think he's been spending a lot of shields.
I don't know if she has shields. Oh no, she has two up there.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Looks like she has at least two.
As weird as it might seem, I might just spend a shield. I guess it depends on really whether the first shot takes him out or not. The first shot
I would
takes
let,
him out.
I would roll the first shot first.
Yeah.
And
it's only one hit.
I already rolled that, man.
Dodges?
Yeah, second shot. Oh, he's got regen.
Regen in the shield.
You have a target. I guess he wants to try and get a missile off on Dengar. That's why he's holding on to the target lock? I don't know.
I think that was dumb.
I think he should have. I definitely think he should have rerolled that first TLT.
Revenge shot. Here's a revenge shot coming?
A revenge shot is still coming.
Yeah.
Yeah,
here it comes.
No, it's a Manaru shooting.
Manaru shoot. Yeah, Manaru
shooting. Okay, he forgot his revenge shot then. Yeah, he forgot his revenge shot.
That was just free damage.
That was free damage.
He could roll, like, a blank and a focus token.
Yeah, he didn't get any hits. Yeah, he forgot his revenge shot that time. Because it looks like they're going back to Dallas. Oh, wait. Maybe he remembered. He did remember. Now he goes his revenge shot.
Ooh, I don't know. Here's one of those janky tournament things. Do you let him take the revenge shot after he's left the step?
That's an excellent point.
Technically we're past it, but...
I mean, good sportsmanship says you do.
Right.
Because he was obviously going to do it. But playing in a regional says...
If the match was close, a ref would probably get called over in that instance.
CPO comes in.
Yeah.
Really making him Zuckus.
The one free evade he gets. Man, what a jerk.
That's Dengar for you.
Leave C-3PO alone. That's not happening. Yeah, it's not happening.
That's brutality. I don't know. This is... This game has become not fun for Jeremy's poor opponent.
Yeah, it's not at all.
I think the debating here on what the reroll, what we were discussing earlier about how C-3PO and stuff works, I think they're probably going to be actually calling over a judge, it seems like, to go through and discuss this.
They call a judge over for this, but they don't call a judge over for the out-of-turn shooting. I always think that's funny.
Yeah,
just a little bit.
It is what it is.
It's up to the individual players here at times. I mean, they haven't gone through. Maybe it technically was probably too far beyond the
not just technically, 100% was.
Yeah. So
he should have taken the revenge shot after the show.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, I would if I was in this game, I probably wouldn't care because I you're basically screwed at this point.
Yeah.
But I always feel I don't know if I like to think I'm a nice person. And I wouldn't want to do that to a person. It's just like, hey, you missed your shot. You could win this game if you hit this shot, but I'm not going to let you take that shot.
Yeah, so because it looks like they made him do the reroll both the dice.
Why?
Yeah.
No, on the Zuckus stuff.
The Zuckus for C-3PO and another result. Yeah. But yeah, going back to that, because I just think that's an interesting topic when you're at the very competitive environment and sometimes people are just so engrossed into the game, they just get really frustrated with any little thing that messes up and you forget things. And sometimes, that little thing doesn't matter, but in instances like this, it's like, if it was a closer game, who knows really, right?
See, the real crime here is if Dengar is gonna live. That's gonna be a real crime if Dengar lives through this.
Yeah, I don't know the result of this one, but I'm gonna guess he's gonna live, man. That's my guess, at least. Unless he rolls a crit when he goes over that debris and kills himself,
that'd be hilarious.
Which would be it would be bloody hilarious. Like, I would be laughing my ass off right now. But we'll soon find out.
So, looks like barrel roll. Trying to get away from range two.
I would just go after that. Go after her. Finish the game. Finish her!
See, I don't know that both of them could take her out in one turn, though.
Oh, no.
She's got they could. She's got six damage left.
Yeah, she's got six damage left. She's got one a shield and five hull left.
It's enough.
Yeah. I mean, Dengar would get to shoot first, and then she would probably suck up a die to regen.
Correct.
Or she might just say, at this point, I would potentially think about sucking up a die and regenning.
And it looks like he's going over, and
he's going to get rid of a stress and add a stress, but like it matters, and he's going to be within range, so he doesn't get the lone wolf.
Right.
But he could crit himself. Crit yourself.
And it looks like
just a hit.
So they're just kind of resetting the board at this point?
It's like three.
I think he might just barely be out of range three.
Yeah.
Well.
Why did the... I guess I can understand it a little bit. I'm just like... Oh, well, you could preserve points. I was thinking, like, why did the Dengar fly away? And why didn't he just fly in with the two ships? But what you can do at this point, technically, is just
preserve your MOV.
Preserve your MOV, fly in with Manaru, finish off to Miranda. Yeah, you can do that easily.
Yeah, he's got 15 minutes left, so he can go chase him down with Manaru.
I would have tunneled so hard and just gone after him.
I mean, Manaru has engine upgrades, so she can technically...
Oh, wow. And Manaru actually bumped.
Yeah, Manaru's got to bump on Dengar.
That was really close.
Bumping big ships is a nightmare.
Well, at least you got the choo-choo train tracks. Which is the one thing I do... One of the rule changes I do like that they added in here was to take the Vassal train track methodology here to go through and line up your bump. Because people in the past just arbitrarily try to...
Eyeball it
and stuff. Yeah. And be totally off.
Oh, you're doing
it. Or some may be at too much of an angle or something.
Well,
it's the
staple of fly casual. You just kind of position it to where it kind of looks good.
Right.
Whereas now you have a very specific way to maneuver. So Miranda two hards in, like I kind of figured. Depends on what Dengarino does.
He's flying away, man. Yep. If he flew away last turn, he's flying away this turn.
Yeah, he's going to get out. He's getting out of the range.
Is it weird that I would have honestly thought about slamming the two straight there?
I don't think that's a bad idea necessarily.
Because you got to figure Dengar's flying away, so you want to make sure you at least get some shots on Dengar soon.
My only concern would be if you didn't eyeball it right and you got into range of both those ships because they're really they're close to each other and you weren't shooting back and you were getting shot on twice.
True, true.
That would make me a really
sad person. So, no shots around. Looks like Miranda now has to come up with a way to at least skin the cat and get rid of Dengar.
You know, that target lock she didn't spend earlier in the game now is coming in handy. Because what she can do...
She can try to get off that homing missile off.
She can try to get that homing missile off. Yes, very much so. So, like a three bank, probably...
I don't know if you're Dengar, you're probably four straight.
You're four straight.
Yeah, your Dengar's just running off and letting Mana rotate and do his dirty work for him right now.
Oh, it's got seismic torps.
Yeah. Well, the seismic torps.
Yes. Glory. We get to witness it. Let's see if he gets a hit, though.
Because you have to roll a hit, right?
Correct. I think it crits count, too, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, that's what seismic... I'm just going to look that shit up real quick.
The wonders of the internet.
The wonders of the apps.
And does he take a damage? He does not.
Each ship at range one of the obstacle rolls one attack die and suffers any damage.
Yep, so no damage happened for...
Yeah, you automatically remove the obstacle, but then you just take one die damage. You treat the obstacle as like a...
Make sure you go through and measure the range one before you remove the obstacle.
Yep.
I've done that before.
Nice part about this situation, though, with Manor only shooting two die, because it doesn't look like it's range one, looks just out. She can just take the hit, no problem, with C-3PO and an evade result.
Like they're checking range.
That might be range one.
Yeah,
okay,
range
one. That's bad.
Yeah.
That's really sad.
Looks like it.
How many die is he rolling?
That's the question.
I'm about to find out.
Oh, so it was out of range. Well,
I think they accidentally
shoot back.
Yeah, he rolled two dice for no reason.
Yeah,
there's the three dice Miranda shot.
All right.
Looks like only one piece of paint.
Yeah, just one. No, you don't focus that one, dude.
Nah. Really?
I think he just did.
Wow. Focused it and dodged it.
Now you regenerate
a shield.
See, now that one's fine. And punch through one damage.
Yeah, gets a shield back, gets a damage on, strips off a shield.
Strips off the shield down. So
it's down from four shields
to
three.
Oh, but he has gonk.
Yeah, true. Yeah, he's going to spend an action to put it on there.
Yeah, but he has pushed a limit too.
But that means he gets stress. And don't forget, left turns are green, not right turns.
Yes, you're right. I always forget. What an awkward ship.
Your right turns basically become barrel rolls, you know?
Right. Your right turns basically.
So at this point, we got about 9 minutes left in the match here.
This game went to time, man. Holy.
At least so far, it's gone to time.
It looks like it's going to go to time. Because with Dengar flying away, I'm pretty sure it's going to go to time. Do we think he kills Dengar?
I don't know. I think Dengar's going to dance around.
Dengar's probably going to do a hard turn.
How many points is Miranda?
Miranda is 43 points.
How many points is Manaru?
Manaru is...
30-something, I bet.
Check here. Da-da-da. Manaru is... 38,
maybe?
40 points.
40 points, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, so if he kills Dengar, he wins.
Yeah, this is going to be close.
No.
It's actually a lot closer game than I thought it was.
He's at 28 points right now, so he kills Dengar. It'll be 40. Jeremy's still ahead right now. It's 57. It'll be 57-40.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because that's the thing is that his. Because don't forget, he lost two of his ships.
Yeah, Nera and the Gold Squadron pilot were 33-24.
Right, but how many points is Dengar?
Dengar is a
don't forget
50,
he's got a 4-point bid.
56 point ship. So
a 4-point bid doesn't matter. That's 4 points automatically
Jeremy
destroyed, really.
If it goes to time and he kills Dengar, Jeremy wins by 1 point. 57-56.
Does it really go points to... does really having a 4-point crutch not count towards your technically 4 MOV lost automatically?
I don't...
Because I'm pretty sure that's how it works. Is that it's... having 4 points is not a negative to the opponent because...
I think it's only a negative to the opponent when you get to the... I think it's only... It stops being a negative if you table.
Right.
If you table, you get the full 100.
Right.
But I don't think here you get a 4-point boost to the cost of Dengar. Because you could all because using that logic, you could also say that, well, no, you get the 4-point boost to the cost of Manaru. I mean, it's just it doesn't. I don't think it works that way. I think the
oh, I see what you mean. Yeah, I see what you mean.
Until you table,
he'll still go through and
such. That's
you have to count the
ship. Yeah.
I'm not a huge fan of MOV. I mean, I guess go with points destroyed as.
So he's defending two green dice.
Somebody.
By the way, looks like he's gonna get
it's
Zuckus
a shot
down.
Back. Yeah. Ooh, Zuckus! Woo!
Yep.
Let's go. What did he roll?
He rolled, wait, 3 green dice. Must have missed something.
I guess it was 3.
Through the refill.
Because, no, C-3PO.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
No,
C-3PO, yeah, okay. Looks like, what is
I
it?
I don't.
3 hits?
I can't tell.
It looks like
no, that's
2 hits.
It's 2 hits. It doesn't look like it's 3 hits.
Looks like 2
shields.
2
hits.
2 shields.
2 shields.
Okay, so he blanked out.
So now he's got TLTs coming back in.
No, it's 3 hits, I guess. Yeah.
Yeah, 3 hits.
He must have got a 3 because he got a shield there.
I tell you, I think you have to spend. You can't spend a shield now, unfortunately.
No.
You have to shoot
the missile.
You have to try to TLT. Oh, does he have? He does have missile, doesn't he? Because he's got target.
You shoot the missile here.
Yeah, you got to shoot. Yeah,
there's the missile.
There's the missile.
Use the chips. Flip to a hit.
Target lock. That is 3.
3. Yep, 3 hits.
Should be 4 hits, really. Should be enough to kill Dengar.
There's the lone wolf, and how much? He's dead.
No, he's got 1 hull left.
Yep.
No, he's dead.
No, he's dead.
No, he's definitely dead. That was 5.
Yeah.
So the missile, yep. would have, if that missile had hit earlier,
it
would
have
been a dead Dengar.
Yeah, this
would
be a much
ago.
Different game.
Yeah.
So that first missile of Nera, he should have shot that.
Yep. So right now we're sitting at, again, Miranda is worth how many points? 40, you said?
Yeah, Miranda's 40.
And then, how much is Manaru worth?
Manaru is 43.
So Manaru is worth more than Miranda.
Well, okay, how many points remaining are on the board? Is that the rule, or is it points destroyed? Because I guess I always forget.
It's points destroyed is how many points you earn.
Right.
So, we have to figure out exactly how many points that the other list is. Once we figure out how many points the Rebel list is, hey David, do us a favor and count up the points of the Rebel list that have been destroyed.
It's 50. Wait, it's 57 points.
So 57 points have been destroyed. Right. Manaru and then Dengar is worth 56.
That's correct. Right.
So that's why the 1 point.
The
victory.
1 point.
Yeah.
Okay. Difference.
Because there 57 points of rebels have died. 56 points of scum have died. Therefore, the game ends right now. Jeremy wins by a point. So it is. So now. He has to try and come up with a way to get Manaru down to half health.
Right.
He's got to kill 3. He's got to kill basically 4 damage points
in
10
minutes.
And
which is doable.
Yeah.
It's very doable as long
about
as
actually
he,
less than 10 minutes. It's like 4 minutes.
Yeah, so he's got to basically fly fast, get in there, not die. Yeah.
My this time, of course, I'm running here as an estimate. It's not exact. I don't know exactly when the timer started for this particular match. And it took these guys about 5 minutes to go through and get set up.
Yeah.
What was the... Do we know that Jeremy's overall record?
We won't talk about this here because we actually talk about that in the next game that we talk about with game number 6 that we record with John Musmore.
Oh, yes, you're right. Yes. That is correct.
Yeah,
so, that is correct.
This is at round 4, but yes, we do jump ahead to game number 6 just because we had one of the players here that was on the game 6. So
yeah, so game 6 has been recorded. If you want to find out what Jeremy's record is, tune into that one. Yeah. Look at me shamelessly plugging our next video.
And many other people in that video.
Absolutely. Lots of people, fun times, explosions,
hamsters.
I
hope you like all those wads of cash in your pants.
That's right. Look, we're so good at advertising for people. We just hope that they turn around and sponsor us.
Vassal, 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 Vassal.
Vassal, 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 Vassal.
What a fucking dumb thing. I mean, my God, I love it. But at the same time, it's like, are you serious?
Vassal, 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 Vassal.
I want to punch somebody in the dick for that. I love it.
I'm sure Ed would let you go through and do it.
I walk in and say, hey, Ed, can I punch somebody in the dick for the vaffle, 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 vaffle commercial? Look at that. Parking dick to dick. They're about to engage in some frottage. Frottage is the act in which two people with penises rub those penises against each other. in a sexual way. Daniel threw up a little bit in his mouth, and it was glorious.
Just a little bit.
Ain't nothing wrong with that shit, my friend.
I'm going to take a step away as I continue.
Holy shit.
This look like a
they almost engaged in a space dock. Just missed the foreskin by that much.
Yep, two shields off of Manaroo.
Look, so
what would be the French word for that, Parker?
What's that?
And not touching.
I don't know. That's a good point. I don't know. Looks like he's calling it. They shook hands. They picked ships up. Probably, they're calling it.
That was probably time that probably ran out there.
That looks like that was literally a 1-point victory.
Yes. Wow. Ultimately, yeah, because we're talking about points destroyed. Yes,
If I was Miranda there, I'm spending a shield. Because I think, did he have a shield left? If he had a shield, he should have spent it to try and get four dice in. Because if he could have gotten a crit, that could have made the difference between...
How much... Did Manor lose a shield previously?
Miranda was down to four. No, the... Manaroo had one shield left at the end there.
Yeah.
Oh, so she did lose her shield earlier.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Oh, so brutal. They didn't gonk either. No. Oh, that almost cost them the game right there.
What a brutal game. That was so close, and there were a lot of near misses for this one. I feel like that again the deployment. If the deployment would have been different and they would have kept. Nira Dantles stuck in to the group more and used that Y-Wing as a blocker, then you could have gotten the double tap Alpha Strike. Sure that basically what's his dick gets rid of he gets rid of the target lock so Miranda can't pop her homing missile, but still you're going to get a proton torpedo right in the face, and that's after Miranda chews down some shields a little bit. Then in the next move, you move somebody else up the block and then just TLT punch him in the face until he dies. Try and get another missile off if you can. You got to pick the right time to streak Nira Dantles off. So you almost kind of want to engage with her, pop a missile, and then try to block with her. And then the next turn, shoot away as fast as you can while still being able to get a focus action so that you can try and get that second torpedo off. And then she just becomes a B-Wing. But missing the opportunities to turreted shot the torpedoes are probably what lost that game.
I definitely agree with that. It was near not shooting at all.
Yeah, that dude flew like a motherfucker. I mean, he flew as best as he could, but the being unable to shoot was a direct result of deployment.
Yes, I agree with that. And
dangling Nira off on the angle. When all of your shit deploys basically after his Manaroo, dude, I don't like that at all. Right. I mean, so actually, it was the Y-Wing, then Manaroo, then Nira, then Miranda, and then Dengar.
Yes. And
I would have just clustered him up and said,
you gotta give credit to Jeremy. He moved right in front of that debris.
Oh, so good.
Got the extra evade with countermeasures of 4-4, discouraged the shot.
Yeah.
And that. Ultimately, it was a game changer right there.
Yeah, because, I mean, if he had made the shot, again, he's got so many modifications because he had popped countermeasures that turn. He didn't have glitter stim, like we pointed out, because he didn't have glitter stim.
No, he had plasma torps and inertial dampeners.
Yeah, so not having glitter stim might have made the difference because I always think they've got glitter stim, you know? But that's real sexy. He could have maybe at that point, if he'd have just done one or two more damage, like one or two additional damage, a Dengar dies that much faster, maybe the Y-Wing would have lived. Maybe the Y-Wing would have survived Dengar, and all of a sudden you're dealing with Y-Wing and Miranda versus Manaroo, and then that becomes a whole different ballgame.
And then you're also looking at Dengar going through and rolling several key evades when he needed to and stuff in there, too. A couple of blanks in there a couple times.
As it gets pointed out to me a lot, if you fly well enough, then your dice become mitigated quite a bit.
Right.
If you don't fly as well, then you really have to depend on the luck of your dice. And we all know that dice fail.
Yeah.
And that's one thing I always constantly struggle with, is trying to fly well enough in order to be able to dagger the shit out of things. Or if my dice aren't as good, my superior positioning will let me live. And that's what I need to work on. But any more closing thoughts about this game before we turn this off and go take a nap?
No, I think I'm ready for a nap.
All right.
I'm about ready for a nap too, man. I'm exhausted after
so
all this.
So from everybody here at Central Ohio X-Wing and the Raven Squadron, we're all saying goodnight. Say goodnight, Daniel.
Goodnight, Daniel.
Say goodnight, David.
Bye.
And this is LP telling you that only you can prevent forest fires. Kill everything. Explode yourselves. Later.